all of life on this planet originated from the oceans 3.7 billion years ago. But today the oceans are in trouble. 90% of large predators have been overfished by humans. Calcium carbonates are losing their ability to generate these protective shields, their shells, because of the excess carbon that is being absorbed into the ocean, changing its acidity level, its pH balance. Coral reefs are disappearing. They're responsible for 25% of life in the oceans. And by 2050, there will be more plastics in the oceans than fish. And that doesn't even address climate change. We've learned that Antarctica is losing up to 300 billion tons of ice per year. That's the equivalent of about 120 to 130 million swimming pools that pour into the ocean every year. Even here in Antarctica, climate change is having surreptitious impact, impacting the entire marine food web, especially here in Antarctica, an environment that is cold, remote, distant, and yet teeming with life, both indigenous and migratory. We have whales and seals and penguins that travel every austral summer to call this home. And of course, the one native species, the emperor penguin, which given the reduction of the sea ice around here, is potentially threatened with extinction by the end of the century. Oceans have a unique role in regulating the Earth's systems. In fact, 90% of the excess heat that is produced by humans is absorbed into the ocean across various layers of the water column. As well, oceans absorb carbon dioxide and other gases. The cooler oceans have a greater absorption rate, which is why the Southern Ocean right here is actually responsible for 50% absorption of the carbon dioxide on this planet. One more reason why we need to reduce our carbon output in order to protect our oceans. Art, and certainly by extension, photography, has a role in generating emotions and drawing us in. We're attached to beauty, and beauty is a conduit from the heart to the mind and can potentially generate a program of action. I mean, we save what we love, and if we can help people essentially fall in love with their world by generating that level of curiosity and attachment, then perhaps in so doing, we can in fact create a program that is designed to preserve it. This World Ocean Day is an opportunity to look at the alarming state of our oceans. The truth is, individual actions really matter. They also lead to all these youth movements that have shed light on our collective responsibility to better our behaviors when it comes to the environment. So, in order for us to realign humans and nature's philosophies, this will require a collective movement, and it starts with you. So, on this World's Ocean Day, I invite you all to contemplate the beauty that surrounds us and the steps necessary in order to protect it.